Welcome to Toy Hill Studio. My name is Kendall Kessler. I put up painting demos and studio tours. Please like and subscribe, and please check out my intro video so you can find out all about me in 2 minutes, where I've been, where I'm going, what my goals are. Last time I did another one of what I call my suggestions paintings, where I paint in an abstract expressionist way, reacting to color and texture. And then if I see some forms in there, I bring them out. Sometimes I add more. This last time I didn't really see much in it. And this happened another time where I had what I consider to be a very strong abstract painting, and I added some very dark silhouettes of birds, and I thought it turned out really nice. So this time I thought I would contrast this very energetic, colorful, expressive painting with some delicate butterfly shapes. And I like it pretty well. But actually, now that I really look at it, if you look over here, you can kind of see a pterodactyl. And in the middle, there's a figure, but I really would have had to work very hard to pull out that face. And there were some other shapes, but I like how it turned out. And now I'm going to move on to hand painting. Hands are very, very hard. It's not only the shape of the hand, the contour changes every little bit. You have to think about this way, that way, all around. It's just a maze of brush strokes. So I'm not really going to do a very representational, pretty much the way things look, representational hand. I'm going to do a very fanciful one, and I am going to still follow some of the contours, but I don't know how long that's going to take, because it does take quite a long time. When I taught at Radford University, I explained to them that, as all art teachers do, that they are really hard to do. And you may not think that, but once you get into it, you realize that it's really easy to make a hand that looks limp, weird, and funny, then to get it to look really right and really natural. Now, I did this as a side view of my hand. As you can see, what I have is my pointer finger, middle finger, thumb, and then it's at an angle so that you're seeing part of my small finger. You can't see the fourth finger. So I'm not really sure what I'm going to do. That's what I really, I said this before, I'll say it again. I really like doing these YouTubes because I don't really plan. I just let it happen and yak while I'm doing it. And it's a real fun experience. I am going to, as I said, I'm going to pretty much follow the contours. I've made this very dark, so I'm not going to lose it. I'm not going to lose the shape of the hand. But I am not going to worry about any kind of natural color. I'm going to do it more like what you saw in the other painting. Just really, really expressing myself, coming up with a visual experience that I think is interesting to look at rather than a natural painting of the hand. Not that it's any better, it certainly isn't. It's just a different approach. But for me, it's always a visual experience. I can take a photograph and reproduce it, but it's still going to be a visual experience. I will not just laboriously reproduce that photograph. It's still going to be arranged in such a way that has a strong impact. I keep using too much of the red. I wanted to get more yellow in there. And of course I've got white. Now I've got black on my palette this time. As I've said many times, I don't usually use black. But I might on this one, especially if I start getting this paint real thick. And then you start to lose the contour of the hand. Yeah, alright, it's starting to get some roundness in it. I'm letting the paint really move around to get that effect. I remember many, many years ago when I was first learning to paint, I did a lot of figures and with hands and all, and I really didn't have that much trouble with it. And I remember the teacher saying that they're very hard, and all students saying the same thing. And maybe for really good, and I asked them, is my hand all right? I said, yeah. And I didn't really think it was that bad, but they're not easy. And I have to really think about it too, but I can certainly do it. It's just you got to really pay attention to the contours. As I told university students, really missed that right there, many times, that anybody can draw a human figure. And it's not good. It's the mark of a true artist to really get it right. And it takes a lot of practice. And that's why we have students work countless hours in front of a figure to learn the figure. Oh, I like that. Getting a little more natural than I thought I was going to do. But we'll see how it goes. Got a real lot of green right through there. Been working real hard to get my computer stuff done today. I have to do so much promo on the computer to sell my work. And I'm just working really hard because I want to get my husband outside. That poor man, he has, if you listen to my YouTube, you already know this, he has been having a hard time since a operation at February 4th. It's like, good Lord. And he's still kind of homebound, and he is a well-known naturalist, Clyde Kessler, well-known naturalist in New River Valley, so you can imagine how hard this is for him to be in so much. So I'm going to take him down to the New River, place where he studies birds and butterflies, and he's mainly just going to sit, because I still can't really get around that much, but we're getting there. We're getting there. Yeah, I'm keeping this real thin. I like that. As I said many times, it's hard to really see the color interaction, how well it's working when you got all that white, but I don't know. This got some nice areas already. Really is quite an experience to do this, not knowing what I'm going to do. I keep forgetting to get it up there because I'm so busy. I want to put up my latest wildflower painting, and I'm going to put it up real soon. And then I want to do one more, same size. And then I want to do some boats at Clater Lake. I love boats, and the form, that wonderful geometric form against the amorphous water, can be just such a beautiful visual experience. That's what it always is for me. It's not so much the boats, it's how it looks as art. And that's how I see all my art. Well, that's kind of cool. I kind of like the way it's dripping, too. Maybe you're going to have a little bit of a better day. Didn't start out real good. But, what am I going to do? I don't know. God, I don't know what to do with the background. I am going to fill it in. I don't know if I should go real dark, green. I don't know. Maybe I'll work with some blue. And the green. I am going to eventually get some white in this. Right now I haven't used any. And I think I would like to. When I was thinking about this today, I was thinking I'd probably get really wild with the background, but I don't know, maybe it might be interesting to have more of a flat area in the background. I can always change it. Acrylics, you can go over and over, and they dry real quick, very quickly, which is always nice, unlike oil paints, which you gotta wait for. And, this might require me to get out the black and really reestablish the hand, because I might start to lose it as I do this. It's a nice effect, though. Oh, I like that. The really strong blue. I can see I'll go outside my picture plane here a little bit, which is no big deal. That's only been 8 minutes, so that's great. I always, as I said many times, just like to keep them like 15, because I think it's just too much to watch somebody paint for a long, long time. But then, as I've said many times, I painted at the speed of light in front of students in Art of Preach classes. You know, most of them were just fulfilling a requirement. They didn't really want to take the class that much. And I tried to make it real interesting with demos and things, and I had them do artwork too. And I did these demos at the speed of light, extremely fast, so that they wouldn't get bored. And then had them do things. So I can do much faster than this. But I think 15 minutes, I think somebody doesn't mind watching YouTube for 15 minutes. When I first started out, they said you should have really short ones. And then long ones. So it's hard to know what to do with YouTube. Well, I like having that texture too. Now I'm not sure what I want to do. I do want to build up that hand more, I think. Which is probably going to require me to start using some white into the paint. Otherwise, it's just going to probably go back in there. And I've got two cups this time because one of them's really getting dirty. So I'm going to move it over here and get the other one closer. A little more organized today, which is always nice. All right, now let me see. I'm afraid I might lose some of that really nice color, though. Painting is always an adventure. I don't care what kind you do. It's always an adventure. I don't want to lose all those complicated systems that I've got going, but I also want to bring it out a little more. Probably the whole thing. Maybe working on this afterwards. I was a little afraid that doing a hand, I would be having to work a lot afterwards, off camera, and I might be doing that. But I think I am going to just, you know, keep it fanciful. I'm still not going to worry about flesh tones or anything. Still just having a good time messing with the color. I think that's probably the way I'm going to go. Just get it more complicated. And get more interaction with the colors, the different colors in the brushwork. As I've said, I know ad nauseum. I like things to be complicated. Don't like minimalism is not for me. There's nothing wrong with it, but I really like things to really get going. Okay, that's kind of interesting. Well, I really am experimenting today. I always do, but I'm super experimenting with this one. Let's see what else I can get going here. Darn it, I keep getting too much red when I want to get the yellow to come forward and get some white into it. I want to get that contour, that part of your thumb that comes up. Okay. Well, I'm liking it a lot better now that there's a whole lot more color, but I always do. Ah, I think I'm going to have to get a small brush in a minute. Say, still only 11 minutes. Oh, I like that. I can move that through there. I'm so glad to get outside. I really do feel sorry for my husband. But he's not the type that can complain. I'm not sure if I mentioned this before, but I think I probably have, that I'm just saying that there's nothing sicker than a sick man. He's not the type. He does his best to just take care of himself and try to even still help me, which is really nice because he's really not in good shape, but he's still trying to help. Okay, at this point, I think I'm going to need a much smaller brush, and I think I probably should just go ahead and really get back into establishing this and getting that contour back. It's been 12 minutes. I'm going to go out just a little bit more. And then I'm probably going to be working on this later when I get a chance. Yeah, I don't want to lose the really nice contours of the hand with the paint dripping around. But I can see there's probably going to be a lot more to do. Well, I never know with these. Sometimes it comes together and I'm done. Other times I really have to go back into the painting. Never know what's going to happen with these YouTube ones, but that's the really fun part about it. I never know. But I can't say I'm happy with this. So that means we're going to be going back into it. It's got some nice areas, but it's not really what I had in mind. And I'm starting to lose the contour of the fingers there. I just do a little something with that and then I'm going to quit and think about what to do with it. And it's so wet that it's kind of messing up. All right. I think I'm going to have to just say, enough's enough. Maybe I'll do just a tiny bit more in the background. I'm going to say enough. See, that's already dried, so now this is going to really fill in very strongly. I don't know if I want to keep it the way it is and not have more complexity in the colors, more complicated systems of colors. I really can talk, but even with a YouTube, I get real nervous because I am talking to people, and I've always been like that, and I tend to make really weird errors just because I get real nervous. If you look at my intro, you'll hear me saying I'm painfully shy, and that really is true. I've always found it hard to be around people. All right, I think I'm just going to say, time to think this one over. Probably get a lot more complicated. Probably add more color in the background, too. So thank you so much for watching. The link to the final painting will be at the top of the description. Link to my Etsy site, my website, my Wix site, and please check out my blog. I'm blogging every day on Wix.